I am having a wooden plank in my hand. This plank is a bit heavy and it has hole here, and there is a slanting cut, not exactly perpendicular, but this is a glass bottle and this is a wooden plank. I am just putting this bottle into this plank hole, and you can see the surprise that the bottle is floating in air horizontal and this is almost vertical. So how come they are in balance? What is the reason behind this equilibrium? The reason is the center of mass of the combined body, bottle and plank, combined body center of mass is here. If the center of mass is here, and if I drop the plumb line, vertical downward line, it passes through the base of this plank. So when it passes through the base, it will have equilibrium, it will balance. So it is law of moments. Now, if you ask me where is the center of mass of this bottle, I can give the answer that it is exactly in the center of my two fingertips. So it is inside bottle. Where is center of mass? It is in the center of my bottle. And this, I can keep the bottle like this, it is stable. If I keep like this, then also it is stable. But a little push will make the bottle topple down, because when I push it little bit, its center of mass will be shifted here. And if the plumb line from center of mass goes out of the base, it will fall. That is simple principle. Now, here it is stable, more stable, because base is broad. Base should be broad for stability, and that is one scientific principle. Now I can take another, okay, where is center of mass of this? Center of mass of this will be between my two fingers, it is here. And this center of mass and this center of mass, if you ask me where is combined center of mass, I can tell you it will come somewhere here. Suppose this is 500 gram and here also 500 gram, equal mass. Then the combined center of mass will be midpoint of the segment joining the two center of mass, two centers of mass. It is very simple geometry. Center of mass of bottle here, here. Center of mass of the plank here. And you have a line segment joining the two, take the midpoint, and that will be center of mass of the combined system. And from that, drop the plumb line, it will fall into the base. And if it is going out of base, it will collapse here. Or it is going out this side, it will collapse here. Either it will fall on this side or that side, depending upon center of mass shifting either right or left. Here, I can show you one thing, one more interesting thing. I got a thin wooden plank, and now I am trying to combine these two and make this stable. Let us see. Yes, I can make it stable. It can remain. Okay. Yeah, it is balancing. Now, surprisingly, how this balance, how it is balancing? Because again, the center of mass combined is having a position from that plumb line is falling in the base. But you must have noted that the angle made by this plank is very large. While the previous plank, which was kept like this, see the angle is very large. This angle is large and this angle was small. It is common sense, because this is heavy weight and that is light weight. We can have one more interesting version where I have got a wooden plank having center of mass here and a bottle having center of mass somewhere here. And if I keep this bottle and keep it on the table, I can get equilibrium. Now I am getting steady state equilibrium, where I observe that the combined center of mass is coming here. And from the combined center of mass, if I drop the plumb line, I am getting in the base. So that is stable. Now, if I remove this bottle, say 200 ml, if I take 300 ml bottle, I can take, and again, surprise, this also is balancing. We will find out reason behind it. This bottle is lightweight, this is heavyweight. But now if I take this bottle and no, it is not stable now. It is falling on this side. Now, why the bottle is falling on this side? Because this bottle has more mass and it has got more moment on this side. So, it cannot remain stable and it falls on this side. But if I take this bottle, the 300 ml bottle, I can get equilibrium. If I take 200 ml bottle, then also I am getting equilibrium. Now, you will ask the question, how we can have small bottle, big bottle, both giving equilibrium? The answer is, the base is not thin, it is broad, somewhat 1.5 centimeter broad. So if now if I put this bottle, center of mass may be coming somewhere here, somewhere on this side, and the plumb line is just falling at this tip. And if I keep the other bottle and I again keep on the table, I will find that the plumb line may be falling somewhere here at this tip. See, it is very difficult to cut the wooden plank and make slope, make the hole that also should be horizontal mounting of this bottle. But you can do this with trial and error. It is a lengthy process, but you can do it by trial and error. It is very interesting experiment which explains center of mass concept. Thank you.